I'm Sara, and I'm back. I wanted to talk to you guys today about how I create my little stained glass patterns, my own little patterns for stained glass. So, because it's just quick and easy to share this, I'm organizing. These are all my patterns, the cats I've been doing. Look, there's a spider web. I don't know if I showed you guys that. That's that, like, abstract one, the houses, the castle. So, all right. Remember in the last video I did, the stained glass video. Now, these are, oh, excuse me. I never finish my sentence, do I? But in the last video I shared, I said I was going to show you how I did the cat. So, I want to do that. And in the meantime, I went down and I looked for some old patterns that I had used. And I've done most of these little stained glass pieces, and I'm pretty sure they were free on the internet, you know, and I just downloaded them. That tulip and this angel are in my kitchen window. So and then this is from the mosaic that I made for Maya, her little princess, the castle. So I have created patterns before. See, that's like, I was gonna make templates, I guess. And then these are just some painting patterns that I was going to do, or that I was going to get inspired by. There's a cute little birdie that I was going to do a stained glass piece with. So anywho, I just put this in a folder, and I'm going to put this in there too. So these are all my stained glass patterns. And I wanted to show you how simple it is to create a pattern using graph paper. Why does this look so dark? It's beautiful right now. It's 3:30 and the sun is out. And my craft room is on the corner of the house that right at this time the sun comes in, so it looks so pretty. But look, so I did these. And I think I want to share with you, basically, I'm probably not going to do it on camera. Yeah, I won't do it. There's a great video I found, because this is the came. This is what I wanted to share. This isn't something that you necessarily need if you're just going to do little sun catchers, you know. But this is like what is it? It's zinc, I think. Maybe it's made of zinc. This piece is just a little wonky, so this is all I have left. Luckily, I had enough for this piece. But you put it around the edges of a panel, and it really makes it stronger. So, but I found a great video about this, and I'm going to link that when I want to share with you how to do that. When I do a video like this, but whatever. So I did this little one just because I think this is so cute. Now, I'm getting a lot of these ideas from Pinterest. I go to Pinterest, and I put in stained glass sun catcher, and you know Pinterest, it's endless. So I've been getting a lot of inspiration and ideas from Pinterest. So, you know, these aren't my total from my brain designs, but it's a heart. I mean, it's not like, you know, hearts are hearts. So and then the cat, I saw a very similar one, and then I've been tweaking it as I went. Remember, because this was the original cat that I did. I'll put these aside, but I'm going to just show you how easy it is to design your own. And see, look how much smaller I made it. See how tall he is? And I like that, but because that's a standalone piece, you know, it's only the head. I made it bigger, but then when I made the cat, I just wanted it to be proportionate to his body. So I kind of made it a little smaller, and I think it looks proportionate, you know, but it's to each his own. If you're making the pattern, you can make your cat any shape you want. So let's do, and then I wanted to just show you this real quick. See, there we go again. I didn't finish another sentence. So I was just playing around with some of the ideas that I saw. Let me see if I can go in a little. Well, that might be too far. There we go. Get this paper in the shot. Look at these little cute girls, right? So these are those gems. And so I picked, say, two orange gems of the appropriately same, or, you know, approximately and appropriately the same size for the boobies. And then you could just make any shape little flowy dress. And then this is another big gem. And then the ones I saw didn't have hair, but I thought, well, maybe I could put a piece of glass around that and give her hair. And if not, I would probably just do like something more similar to this where it's just a piece of wire and I could connect that to give her hair. This was an angel, a very simple angel again with the gem. And these, you don't have to use a gem. I mean, just cutting a circle out of stained glass is pretty hard. So if you can, if you get a ready-made circle, it's a lot easier to just throw that in there. And it gives the piece dimension and it makes it different, you know. And then these are just wings. And then this is wire with a little bead. So you could put a bead on there. And I'm thinking about that too. I was going to give this cat a collar with beads. I bought the beads, but I never did it. And again, see, here's another one. And her dress is just shaped differently, you know. So they're buddies, and you know, you can make your mom or anybody, your best friend, make them look like that. And then this is just wire, so I think it would probably go like this with a twisty at the bottom. I don't know. I mean, I would wing it and figure it out, but then this piece of wire would just connect here and then connect here. Same thing over here. And then this one just bent out and maybe has a twisty at the bottom. And look at this, like a free form angel. You know, but, and then this is where I came up with these two heart designs, because I'm still working on something for Fran. My cousin Fran is a very clean, her decorating style is very clean and functional, you know. So I'm a lot more whimsical and colorful. So just because I like it doesn't mean she's gonna like it. And I want it to be a surprise. So I wanted to come up with a few different items in her colors, because this is her colors. I've been telling you guys this. This is like, her bathroom is painted this blue color, and then she accented it with lavender. And I don't have any lavender really, so I've been trying to find purples, but this is her color. So I keep making things with these, because she loves cats, with these colors. I did the small castle, but now I'm thinking, I'm just gonna do a heart. I'm gonna do, because maybe a heart is just as much as bold as she wants to go. You know, I mean, I know she likes cats, but maybe she wouldn't like, I don't know. So I'm gonna bring a couple options when I go. Because I'm having fun anyway. It doesn't bother me. But this was so simple to create and to design. So I'm gonna create another one of these. I'm gonna go a little bigger and I may turn it this way. I don't know. I wanna use, so let's get started. I'll show you. And then this little guy, so easy. All right, so I'm going to take, this is about 8.5 by 11, right? Is that what it would be? My thing is backwards here. Wait a minute. Yeah, approximately 8.5 by 11, right? So I'm going to utilize this whole paper for the big, for this one. I'm just going to make it a bit bigger. So I'm going to utilize, and I'm probably going to keep it, I don't think it would look right if I made the heart, which, I mean, it could look fine, you know? I don't know what to do. I think I want to go this way just because I haven't done it yet. And you know what? I'm going to move the pad away so that you can see just on the my craft mat here. So basically, I just start making a shape. And this graph paper is fantastic because, you know, I mean, if you have a specific size in mind, you know, maybe we'll go 8 by 10 or something. Let's see, because this is 8.5, right? Where the heck are my, here we go. Oh. Sorry, I turned my mat around so much I can't, I don't know where my numbers are. 8.5. So it's not going to be exactly 8 by 10. But that's a good size to go with. And let's see where 10 is. 10 is about here. So I'm going to start like two off the edge and go all the way to, it'll be close enough. And so when I say two off the edge, I mean two block, the two grid marks, you know. And I'm just going to create that, the box. Then I'll show you how I do it. See, this one I stayed two off the bottom, and this, well, that's because of the grid. I had, there's two full grids on this side and there was only 1.5, anywho. Look, this is how I do it. You don't have to do it this way and there's no wrong way to do it. Okay, so I have my basic, hopefully, yeah, you can see that. So let's see, then I'm gonna find my center. And for this one, actually, I think I went off a notch from my center. So yeah, I went over a quarter inch because I wanted this side to be bigger than that side. So I'm gonna do that again. Maybe I'll go over two, but you wanna find your center. It's just easy. So it's 10, so we'll go with 5. So here's my center. We'll do it on all sides. So we'll find the center because it just helps you get things proportionate. So this was actually only 7 1/4. So it's not 8, or 7 3/4. Maybe I'll take it up. Nah, that's okay. So 4 would be a little off. So I'll go right here in between this, that grid. Oop, my tummy's growling. We're gonna have dinner soon. It's almost 4 o'clock. So I do think I want to go over. I'm gonna go over 2. So I'm gonna make a line that goes straight down to the bottom, and then we're gonna start creating a curve. So from this middle line, it depends. This could either be a chubby heart or a tall. I think that's a good place to go from. So I'm going to make this side go straight down to the center line. No. It has to go to this line. So forget about your center for now. Let's go. And that's just a straight line. Now I'm going to play with curving it. Let's see how wide I want this to be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think it should be 8. So I'm going to put a mark there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then I make a mark. And then how many down do I want to go? I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to go 5 down. So that, I mean, I don't know if it's going to look proportionate or not. And then we got to figure out how far over we're going to go too. I think I'm going to, this side's bigger. So let's see, I'm going to center it and then I'm going to give it 3 on each side. And that's how I'm going to build my curve. All right. So basically I just let the pencil do the work. So if I want a curve, I'm going to go from here to here and curve it. And then you don't want this to be too square. So kind of curve up to it and then curve away from it to reach over to here. And then go down, and then I'm going to start curving. So this is going to be a little less straight. I'm going to make it and you know what, you can even see, I just let the pencil tell me where to go, but that looks pretty proportionate to me. It's big. This might be a little too wide. I think I might want to go up a little. I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think 6 might be wide enough. I'm gonna try it. Ready? So we're just gonna come off of that. And because I'm gonna cut this out, I like that better. So I have this little eraser, and I'm just gonna erase this and erase this original line. So you can just keep tweaking it and seeing how proportionate. See, this I might want to go down more too. We'll see. So let's make this curve. And on this one, I made this one kind of go in and up. So I'm just going to let the pencil, like I said, go up and over. And I don't know if this is appropriate for this shape of a heart, but I'm just going with it right now and saying, and like over here, I don't want it to be 8 anymore. I want it to be 6. So that one and then this one. So actually, I'm going to change that and make it come from right here. But with the graph paper, it's super, it helps so much to keep it proportionate. And then just let your hand find the curve. So it's a little, this is so big over here, but I don't know, it may look super cool. I'm not sure. We're not sure yet, guys. All right. So then, how do I want to do this? Because this was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think I'm going to do 6. I don't know. I just feel like changing it. So we're going to go over to here. Take this curve. I don't think that's going to be enough. I think I'm going to use the 8. So we're just going to take this and curve it down to this part. And then we're going to go to here. So how many, I only used 3. 3 up here, so we're going to curve it to here. Oh, that's what I was going to say. You can actually look, like, did you guys ever do that in the, I think it used to be in the funny papers when I was a kid, and there'd be a picture in a grid over here, and then you were supposed to draw the picture in the grid over here. This was an empty grid, and you just drew exactly what was in this grid over here, and by the end, you drew that picture. So it's kind of like that, you know, you're basically, you're just, you can look at the little grid to get your line straight. So what do we think of this? I kind of think I might want to go down further. I think I do. And I think I only did 3 over here and I did 6. I don't know what I was thinking. But I think I'm going to do, go down a little further. So both sides. And only do 3, so it's going to come from there. And I think I want to go to here, 3 more. So let's see what that looks like. So we're going to go to here, to here. And I'm curving, so I'm just letting my, kind of, I eyeball it in such a way that I can kind of see it. I don't know, I'm just, I guess I'm just, it's easy for me to do that, but it seems like it's easy. I don't know. So you're just, create a curve. Yeah, that actually looks so much cuter. Yeah, I don't know about this. This might be a little too wide, and this is a little off. So I'm going to keep tweaking it, and then eventually I'm going to create a grid. So let's see. I'll go across, let's see, right here. And right here, and we'll put one here. So this is just wherever, and it's like patchwork. It's a patchwork, so you can't go wrong either. And each one of these will be a different color of red, or I'm going to do Fran's color, so it will be a mixture of the purple and the blue, and maybe I think all this outside will be a clear. So, and that's it. That's basically it. That's what you do to create a pattern. And it's then that way it's yours. You know, this is, someone else might have done a patchwork heart, but I've never, you know, this is my patchwork heart. So let's go across here. Stick my head in there, watch out. And I want to do a thin one here, thinnish. And you can really get yourself like crazy over, you know, like, it, oh, this kind of looks like an American flag almost or something, doesn't it? Let's see. I kind of want to do a little one right here. And something kind of over here. And you can just tweak it any way you want. I think I want to do this one. I kind of like being big, but I kind of might want to do, I like this big piece. I don't know. I don't know. Also, every intersection that you make is, you know, I'm putting solder there, so you're, I don't know. So that's why the came around the edges is going to make it really firm. So I want to leave that and I want to leave that, but I think I'm going to break this up into something like this. Put my line. Kiwi, come here and see. Come see everybody. Come here. Yes, yeah, stay right. No. Stay on my arm. I kind of wanted you to see what she was doing because she's so cute. I want to do... Oh, my tummy is growling. Something like this. Now I'm getting a little crazy, you know? Because that's what I don't know when to quit sometimes. Do I like this big long one? I do. I think I might want to do... All right, anywho, you know, you get the idea. And then you would go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and number each piece. Then you choose what colors of glass, and you cut this apart. And, you know, I'll do another video on that. But I wanted to show you this, the cat, real quick. Let's just do a cat. Because you can make your cat any size you want. So for this one, he was pretty big. I'm going to just move him over. So let's just do the cat. And I won't even look at that one, and I'll just try to do it however he turns out is what we're going to get. So, like, that looks good. I think that's a good size. So let's go with that. And you just start out with a square. And then you can... You know what? I'm not even going to go there because those are his ears. So I'm just going to put his top of his head like right here. I mean, you can make a square cat. You can make a square face if you want. I'm going to wait to add the points because I want to see where my design goes. So you definitely need a nose and a mouth and the cheeks. So let's just get our shape first. I'm going to stick with and go down, and we're just going to put a chin in. So let's go with, oh, my tummy is growling. I think I'm going to go five up. Five up this time, and we're going to go two on the bottom. So here, and actually that looks centered. There's six, two, and six. Six and six is 12. 14 squares across. So now I'm just going to curve this down to my chin. Oop, this isn't working very well. That looks pretty bad. All right, let me see who this is just in case. It's my son. Okay. Thanks for that, Matt. Curve it. Okay. And then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Hopefully, you know, try to get it proportionate. There you go. And it's not perfect. This actually looks a little higher than that, so I'm going to go down a tiny bit. All right. Now, he needs a nose, and I like to give him that little part between the nose. What is that called? Oh, man, I know what it's called from doing faces. And then you also give him a mouth. So we're going to go from here to here, and I could have used my ruler, but I'm just going to go there to there. That's kind of like his little mouth, a philtrum. I think it's called a philtrum, right? And we're going to give him a nose. So two. These are kind of mirroring each other. But I want to curve this. And then we're going to connect, make a curved bridge of his nose. So I'm going to start at the corner here at the end of his nose. And just do a gentle curve. So start here and maybe go over one grid. Or not even, you know, half a grid maybe. Three quarters it turned out. So I'm going to go over three quarters. Three quarters, Sara. And, oops. Get your nose. So he's looking kind of like a cat, right? Ouch. I don't know why I always say he for my cats. All right, so then he needs eyes. But let's put a line here because when you're cutting, this is a very important part of it, and I haven't mentioned this yet. You want to create lines. That was off. You want to create lines that are cuttable, because when you're cutting glass, you can break your pieces, or you can make it in such a way that you won't be able to get that curve or that, you know, without making it very awkward. So basically, I'm going to be able to cut a triangle very nicely, two triangles, and this piece should be able to be cut very nicely. This is just scrap, right? We're not using this. This was just so that we could get our proportions. So that's not part of our design. And so you want to make, so this piece we can cut perfectly fine. You just want to make sure you have, and then if you're using those little, let's see, these guys. I usually take some and decide if I'm going to do blue eyes or green eyes or look at this, teal eyes. And I put them in. So these are about 2 grids wide, and so I'll kind of mark that. Now that looks about good. I mean, you could go lower and you could have a higher forehead, you know, and a littler cheek, or you could go higher and you'd have a much bigger cheek and a smaller forehead, but I'm just going to center it, and this happens to work out fine. I have 3, 2, and 3, so I'm going to put, you know what, I'm just going to center it. I'm going to make a center line. See, I'm changing it. It seems like I change every single time. I never do two the same. I guess it's just what I feel like for that day. So I'm going to connect this to that bridge of his nose line. And just so when I solder, it kind of, or I could go over. Wow, let's try that. I don't know what it'll look like if I go all the way to the middle. Might look pretty cool. You're on my arm. I want everyone to see you. Why don't you get on this arm? Come here. No, stay. Well, she won't stay down. Do I like that? I don't know. Let's see. It changes it so much, doesn't it? Oop, I'm running out of eraser. It changes it, I think, when you put, I can't decide. I have a hard time making decisions. So now for the eyes, I'm going to just make marks here, and we're just going to arc over this 2. We want to keep the eyeball kind of in the center here. So I'm going to make an arc, and it doesn't have to be all the way to this point, but I haven't done one like this yet, so that's why I'm doing it. And I'm going to arc it to here, to the 2. Arc it to there, and then, you know, and do the same thing. So you arc it, arc it, arc it. This is the cutest one I've done, and look, I like that. Now these, because on pretty much all of the other cats I've done, I've left this gap here, which I thought was very artistic and very cool, and I don't hate it, but I've not actually ever done one with the eye connected. So I'm changing it, and I'm doing it that way. And again, I'm just using my grid to make it, especially eyes, you want them to be, what? The word is not coming to me. Concentric, that's not the right word. I cannot think of the stinking word. Look at, that's cute. I'm really liking this. Now you would just have to make sure that your bead fits in there. And that's basically it. I don't think I do love, the only thing I want to say about now on this one, I split the ear in half just to add more color. So that's an option. You can do that. You could make it, I was thinking of making it like this, because you know how a cat has, you can see the back of his ear and then he has the pink inside of his ear. That's what I was kind of, I like that idea. I think I'm going to go back to my original size though. And then maybe we'll split it in half. I'm yelling. You know why? Because I took my energy drink today and I'm just yelling. But I don't know if you need it, but it's an option. And every time I do one of these, he's different. And so I'm kind of liking, that it's that way, that he's different, you know? And because no two cats are alike, right? So there you go. And then after, I added his whiskers on this one, and I put them above his nose, and they should go down here. I would give him whiskers down here, because this is his snout area. You know, this is like above his eye, so his whiskers would go there, and he may have eyebrows or eyelashes, so you could just add some wire there. But isn't he handsome? I like him. I'm gonna have to make him. So that's it, you guys, and I wanted to just show you this tiny little heart that I did. Super simple. You know what, I'm just gonna get the pattern. It's right here. Look at this. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 16 across. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 down. And then, so you're 8 here. And this is what? It's not 7. I went up. See how I didn't do it in the center? So let me see my little guy that we were doing. So yeah, see, I did it again. This is the center, but I went up because a heart is kind of... Actually, this one might look cuter bent this way because it's bigger. I'm gonna tweak this a little bit because this is the piece I'm gonna make for Fran. And then when you're done your creation, just go make a couple copies of it because you're gonna wanna cut it out and use it for your pattern. So when you choose your glass, you glue these little pieces to the colors of glass that you wanna use. And you're off on your way to making a stained glass masterpiece. All right, you guys, so that was fun. Thanks for watching.